Top story at 5:30 reports that high school athletes are put at risk by continuing to play even though they have concussion-like symptoms. The Peters Township Police are investigating this.
A parent we spoke with is outraged, saying their child was put in harm's way. Channel 4 Action News reporter Sheldon Ingram shows us even Children, Youth, and Families is involved in these serious allegations.
The Peters Township School District has drawn the attention of police because of the alleged actions in the football program. Trainers raise concerns about kids being pressured to play even while nursing serious injuries. This is video of the Peters Township football program in 2009, but the allegations focus on the most recent training camp for the 2011 season. Concerns about the program
started with two trainers who work here at Mortland Physical Therapy, and it is the owner of the facility who brought this matter to the attention of the Peters Township School District.
He is Mark Mortland. His business provides two trainers to oversee athletes for the sports programs at Peters Township High School.
I've never seen it before, just where you question an injury right from the beginning when it hasn't even been appropriately evaluated yet. There was a kid evaluated during camp. My trainers, he came over the sideline, had a sore wrist. Kid got hollered at, so did my trainer. There's nothing wrong with him. Get back in there, tape it up. The kid came to school the next day with a cast on.
What's wrong?
He broke his wrist.
Mortland says another football player was diagnosed with concussion symptoms by his trainers.
The kid and my trainer were pressured, saying that you don't have a concussion, you just have a headache, get back here and play.
That child's father wrote a letter to the Peters Township School Board about the incident. He says, quote, the football program was giving Grant and Andrew a hard time all week, telling them that he was clear neurologically and should be practicing with the team. After visiting a specialist, the letter says, quote, as it turns out, after our appointment with the doctor at UPMC, Grant did sustain a concussion. The family says they were told, quote, that if Grant had sustained another concussion soon after the first one, he could have had severe brain damage. School Superintendent Nina Zetti says the district found no wrongdoing by the football program because it is not their responsibility to allow injured players to play or practice. It's the trainer who has the final say. And the superintendent says, according to the trainer, no student was allowed to play without a medical release. Meanwhile, the Peters Township Police Chief says they're investigating these and other allegations to see if they warrant charges. Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.